Our guest has come your way right now. He is a Grammy award-winning singer, songwriter, producer, and performer. You know him for his soulful sound, but now he's taken his music in a new direction with his brand new album, World Music Radio. Please join me in welcoming the incredibly talented Jon Batiste to Fresh Out Live.
What's happening?
It's good to see you, brother.
Whoa.
Take it all in. One more time for Jon right here.
Thank you. Hey, yes.
Thank you. Hello. Hello.
Yeah. You have been a busy, busy man.
Yeah, you got to do it while you can get it.
There you go.
You know?
There you go.
That's
and
it.
21 tracks on this new album. Not just a new album, but 21 tracks. I mean, that is quite the body of work for World Music Radio. And those are some dope headphones. I just had to tell you that on the cover right there.
Yeah. Look out for those.
Yeah, those are very cool, dude. So 21 tracks, what inspired this body of work? Kind of take us inside the mind of Jon as you were making this.
Well, if you can imagine it, you can do it. And if you liberate yourself, others, when they're around you, will be liberated. And I create in the space right now. It's a spiritual place where I'm trying to liberate the world. World Music Radio came to me in a dream, and it's literally music for the whole world. And it's breaking this idea of genre, because we're getting freer spiritually. We get into a place where we're freer. So I think it just represents where everybody is collectively around the world in the generations to come. It's some other stuff that's happening. So I'm forecasting something. And I believe I'm right about it. So that's why I made this.
Yeah, absolutely. That universal language of music.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's right.
Now, you know, much is to do and much has been said about the new direction sonically of the record. But, you know, we talked about your love of jazz music and just that form of music, just from even an instrumentation standpoint, it's very eclectic, right? And you're sort of balancing a lot of different elements. So did you find this to be a departure artistically with the new sound, or did you find it sort of, were you accustomed to it because of your jazz background?
You know, that's interesting, because all of this within me and within the collaborators that I worked with, and if it's within you, it's you. Whether people know it about you or not, it's still you. And that's the kind of thing that it took 20 years for me to get to a place where I could play certain things on the piano. It took me 7 or 8 years to learn certain dance steps. It took me this long to learn how to sing this or do that. It took me about 10 years to conceive of how to make this record and blend all of the music that I know into something that somebody could just rock to in a whip, or just be with their family or your grandparents or your kids. Just to create something like that, it took like 10 years for me to be able to sonically craft that. So, you know, I think all of that's a part of the journey. When I was 21, focusing on jazz, then developing my concept of social music, expanding that. We talked about that a lot. Playing music in the street. I'm from New Orleans, I can't help it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
it's like,
it's in you.
It's layers of it, man. I'm excited for what's to come. Who knows what else is within us as people? Don't limit yourself. That's all I'm saying. Don't limit yourself.
Absolutely.
You got it. Don't limit yourself.
Amen. You brought up New Orleans. I got to go there next.
Let's go.
You got a New Orleans
come on,
legend.
504, man.
Right along, another New Orleans legend. Let's talk about Uneasy, your track with Lil Wayne.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know how far you guys would go back if you're across paths just in your hometown, but tell us about how this record specifically came about.
So 17 Ward, first represent. We didn't cross paths, but coincidentally, we grew up 3 minutes away from each other in Holly Grove in the 17 Ward. And what's crazy is we were in a lot of the same circles. And my family's a very big musical family in New Orleans. We had heard of each other. Obviously, by the time he was 14, I was 8 or 9 years old, he was a superstar. So we connected in New York, not in New Orleans.
Crazy.
And the thing about it is we had been wanting to work since my last project, but it didn't come together. But it was meant to happen. Because this and Philip Umans, shout out Philip Umans, the director, it's a short film. It's like a whole, he created something. He's from New Orleans too, so
And it just blends you two together so beautifully. I mean, he loves obviously skateboarding.
Yeah, that's really cool. Those are his skaters.
We don't have too much more time, but I did want to congratulate you. Jon is up for 2 Video Music Awards this year, which is huge. I'm just curious, with the show coming up this year, this is a show that we all grew up watching. Is there a VMA moment that comes to mind for you that you were like, wow, I'll never forget that?
Yeah, yeah. The real Slim Shady.
Oh, with all the blonde dudes.
Bruh.
Yeah. Yeah.
The creative on that was crazy.
That was wild.
Vision, that's the perfect creative for the song.
It yeah.
was just like, for a live performance to
yeah.
do that, and to think of having all of them there.
Wild.
Crazy vision. I love that.
Now you got to bring about like a 30 Johns with you.
I might do something.
On September 12th.
Let's go.
All right. We are unfortunately out of time. It's a quick show today, Jon. But thank you so much for stopping by, guys. One more time for Jon Batiste. World Music Radio.
Yes.
World Music Radio out now. 21 tracks. Have an awesome weekend. For Jon Batiste, I'm Kevan Kenney. Peace, my man.